Welcome to our chemistry lesson today. We will be discussing thermochemistry, that is energy exchanges in chemical and physical processes. This is our third topic, and we will discuss something called molar enthalpy of combustion. Molar enthalpy of combustion. Now in Form 3, we did some exercise on combustion as one of the chemical reactions under organic chemistry, and we saw what happens when some compounds are burned in oxygen. Now, first we will begin by defining what molar enthalpy of combustion means. So let's begin with the definition of molar enthalpy of combustion. Now we can say this is the heat change, molar enthalpy of combustion, is the heat change, we can say the enthalpy change, is the heat change that occurs when one mole of a substance, it is the heat change that occurs when one mole of a substance is burned in oxygen. Molar enthalpy of combustion is the heat change that occurs when one mole of a substance is burned in oxygen. When we talk of a substance, the substance in this case could be an element. You could be dealing with an element, you could be dealing with a molecule, or you can be dealing with a compound. We discussed this in Form 1. We divide what an element is, what a molecule is, and what a compound is. So in this case, if you are dealing with an element, for example, you are given carbon, is an element. We are saying when it is burned in oxygen, then you will get a compound. In this case, you get carbon 4 oxide. So one mole of this burned in oxygen give us. So at the end of this, you will have some heat that will give an out. For example, 393 kilojoules per mole. So meaning that when one mole of carbon is burned in excess oxygen, give you carbon dioxide, the amount of heat released is about 393 kilojoules per mole. So this is an element. Now, it could be a compound. For example, you are given methane. We came across this in Form 3 under hydrocarbons. When you burn methane in oxygen, it gives you two products, carbon 4 oxide and water. It gives you carbon 4 oxide and water. Two moles of that. And two moles of water. So one mole of methane burned in oxygen, you get carbon dioxide, with some energy given out, enthalpy of combustion around maybe negative 189 again kilojoules per mole. So these are examples to explain this definition, that this heat change that occurs when one mole of a substance is burned in oxygen. I'm saying that the substance could be dealing with an element, could be dealing with a molecule, for example, hydrogen gas, or a compound, like we have seen in the case of methane. Now we have a setup here that we want to use to calculate the molar enthalpy of combustion of ethanol. When we were discussing organic chemistry too, that is alkanols and alkanoic acids, we saw how we can prepare ethanol. And in Form 1, we say that ethanol is a drug, and therefore some people misuse it. Now, in our latest topic, when we are discussing alkaloid acids and alkanols, we say that alcohol can be used as a drink. But remember that you are students, and therefore we want to warn you that these are drugs, and it should not be consumed by people below the age of 18. So I want to encourage you that we don't, as much as we say it's an alcoholic drink or it's used as a drink, I'm not encouraging you learners to take it because it is not good for your health. Thank you. Now let's look at this setup that we can use to determine the molar enthalpy of combustion of ethanol. What do we have here? We have a bottle which has ethanol, and there is a wick which has been burned to produce a flame. We have the ethanol in that bottle. We have tripod stand to support our glass beaker here. We have wire gauze. We have a thermometer to record the temperature. We have distilled water. Then we have some piece of cardboard screen to shield the flame. We need to ensure that the flame is steady all through. So we have cardboard screen to prevent draft, cardboard screen to prevent draft, so that we maintain a steady flame, because at the end of the day we want to know the mass of the ethanol that will have burned at the end of the experiment. So as you hit this, as you burn the wick, so the flame will hit the water. Therefore, the thermometer will register the temperature at the start of the experiment and then at the end, so that it can help us in calculating molar enthalpy. Let's look at this. We are told that in an experiment to determine the molar enthalpy of combustion of ethanol, a student obtained the following results. We are told to use the results to calculate the molar enthalpy of combustion of ethanol. So we have a known volume of water which was used, 100 centimeters cube. We have initial water temperature. At the start of the experiment, the temperature of the water was 28 degrees Celsius. Then at the end of the experiment, it rose to 43 degrees Celsius. Initial mass of the bottle and its contents was 28.25 grams. After the experiment, the mass of the bottle together with the contents dropped to 28.02 grams. We are given the density of water as 1 gram per cubic centimeters, specific heat capacity of water, 4.18 kilojoules per kilogram per Kelvin. And then now we can use this information to determine what will be the molar enthalpy of combustion of ethanol. So first, we need to get the mass of water. So mass of water will be given by volume times density. Volume times density, which is 100 cubic centimeters times 1 gram per centimeters cube, which is 100 grams, or you can convert to 100 to kilograms for easy calculation, 0.1. So first, get the mass of water, volume times the density. Next, let's get the change in temperature. Change in temperature. We call that delta T, which is 43 minus 28. That would be 15 degrees Kelvin. Let's add degrees Kelvin. Why am I? We can have it as degrees Celsius or degrees Kelvin, because in our specific heat capacity we have a Kelvin, so we must have a value of Kelvin. Then the next step is we want to work out now the amount of heat released, amount of quantity of heat released. We use this as a formula, MC delta T, where M stands for the mass that we have worked out here, C is the specific heat capacity, and then delta T or change in temperature is what we already have here. So our mass is 0.1 kilograms multiplied by 4.18, we've said kilojoules per kilogram per Kelvin, and change in temperature, which is 15 degrees. Okay. So from this, this cancels with that, and then Kelvin, and then, so we remain with kilojoules as our final units. Class, can we work out that? 0.1 times 4.18 times 15. Yes, correct. You get 6.27 kilojoules. I'm still insisting on the proper presentation of the units, small letter K and capital J. That is the format. So remember, always lowercase k and capital J. Next step is we want to work out the mass of ethanol. Mass of ethanol. And we'll be now 28.25 minus 28.05. You get 0.23. That is the mass of ethanol is burned at 0.23. We want to work out the number of moles, so therefore we have to find the relative formula mass of ethanol. So relative formula mass of ethanol, ethanol CH3CH2OH, that is, we have two carbon atoms, so 12 times 2 hydrogens, we have 5, 6, that is 1 times 6, and then 16 of oxygen. That will be 24 plus 6, that is 30 plus 16, give us 46. That is the relative formula mass. Therefore, number of moles will be now mass 0.23, we divide by the relative formula mass. That will give you 0.005 moles. That is the moles of ethanol. Then, now we want to relate. This number of moles releases this amount of heat energy. 0.005 moles of ethanol. And do it here. So we say 0.005 moles releases 6.27 kilojoules of heat energy. Releases 6.27 kilojoules of heat energy. Now, what this is, what about one mole? One mole of ethanol would release 6.27 over 0.005. So if this number of moles releases 6.27, what about one mole? It would release 1 times 6.27 divided by 0.005. And you do that accurately, well, so you get 1,254 kilojoules of heat. That is the amount of heat that would be released, one mole of ethanol. Therefore, the molar enthalpy of ethanol, therefore, the negative 1254 kilojoules per mole. The molar enthalpy of combustion of ethanol. Molar enthalpy of combustion of ethanol. Enthalpy of combustion of ethanol is negative. Now, we'll introduce a negative sign here, getting that the reaction or this enthalpy of combustion is an exothermic reaction. So it is an exothermic reaction releases some heat. The final stage now is to write the thermochemical equation. We write the thermochemical equation. So we have ethanol and water, and then delta H here, delta H is negative 54 kilograms or more. So finally you write the equation, and at the end of that equation you get the heat change. So now delta H C combustion negative 1254 kilojoules per mole. That is the thermochemical equation. We need to balance that equation to ensure that it is correctly written. So we require 3 moles of oxygen, 2 of carbon dioxide, and 3 of water. So a thermochemical equation is a balanced chemical equation, and at the end of that equation we have the molar enthalpy. Obtained after working out. If you are told to write the or draw an energy diagram, or energy level diagram, sorry, to show that information, then you say it on our y axis, you draw energy. And then on our x axis, we have the reaction progress, and our reactants will be up here, that is ethanol and 3 moles of oxygen. And then we have our reactant, the products here, carbon dioxide, we have 2 moles of this and 3 moles of water. And then our delta H C negative 1254 kilograms or more. That is what is expected. So follow all these steps, work out the mass of water, get the change in temperature, that is delta T, get the amount of heat released, mass and the specific heat capacity and the change in temperature. Get the mass of ethanol was burned, and then work out the relative formula mass, get the moles, and then bring in the relationship that this number of moles releases that amount of heat. Whatever 1 mole, because our interest is to get the mole, 1 mole of ethanol would release what amount of heat energy, and we have correctly worked out and put it as 1254 kilograms. Then molar enthalpy of combustion of ethanol therefore is negative, to show that the reaction is exothermic. So you must indicate the sign at the end of the answer that you have obtained. Then write the thermochemical equation, and finally the energy level diagram. And if you come across that equation, believe I now you can comfortably solve it.